Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today is March 23rd. We're going to talk about the do's and don'ts of spring fertilization. Let's get into it.
Traditional wisdom might have you believe that you want to get a bag of fertilizer on the lawn as soon as it starts to green up. However, that is not the case. The first thing you're going to want to do is get a soil test. It's not a flashy thing to do. It'll help you save time and identify problems in your lawn that can save you money and headaches down the line.
Generally speaking, you're going to want to avoid early season nitrogen applications. Once the soil reaches 50 to 55 degrees, it's going to start growing and hit what we call tiller town or the spring flush. You will not need nitrogen in order to push this along. Microbial activity is also slow as things start to wake up and the soil start to warm up. And this actually reduces competition for nitrogen in the soil and part of the reason that we get a spring flush. There's also an excess of carbohydrates that have been stored over the winter and during the fall that the plant is taking advantage of to drive your roots down super deep. Your roots are going to develop pretty much two times a year, spring and fall, and these are the deepest times that they'll actually end up growing. Do's and don'ts with nitrogen are very simple. We are going to delay the use of nitrogen in the early spring until after the grass greens up and hits that flush stage where it's just growing, 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 and greening and greening. We're also only going to use moderate amounts of nitrogen. We're delaying nitrogen because we do not want the plant to use its carbohydrate reserves on top growth. The top growth will happen naturally during the spring flush. We'd rather have that excess carbohydrate go to the roots. We also do not want to encourage fungal activity into late spring and early summer. Excess nitrogen will definitely boost that. However, if you do have a good fungicide program and you're running a spoon feeding problem, this may be an issue that you don't worry about.
If you are going to make an application, consider getting a preemergent in order to stop things like crabgrass and other weeds from growing in your lawn. However, they do sell these preemergents with nitrogen, and you should avoid that for first application with the nitrogen as we've been talking about. You might also consider adding an application of molasses, iron, seaweed, or humic to your lawn. However, there are a few reasons where you may actually want to apply some nitrogen as early as you'd like. Those areas would include highly trafficked areas, shaded areas, new turf stands, so if you did a renovation or a heavy overseed. And just remember, if you decide that you want to go ahead and put nitrogen or you do have a good reason to put nitrogen down, keep it in moderation, so anywhere from 0.1 to maybe 0.5 pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square feet. I'm gonna follow my own advice and I'm gonna wait till about April 15th to put down my first application of nitrogen. This will be a spoon feeding program that I do every 2 weeks that will involve about 0.2 pounds of ammonium sulfate per 1,000 square feet. We'll also be encouraging a pretty decent, I think, fungicide program that we'll talk about here in a few weeks. So if you wanna see what I do to my lawn and stick around, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.